Hello and welcome to the BMC Atrium Core CMDB video series. This video is an overview of the new reconciliation component in CMDB. After you log into CMDB, go to the Dataflow section. The reconciliation component shows a snapshot of the total number of CIs identified and merged, including those that failed, which are shown in red. Click the reconciliation component. This is the interface from where you perform the CMDB reconciliation tasks. You can filter the displayed information on the basis of datasets and time period. For example, select a specific dataset and a time period such as last 7 days. This screen provides a consolidated view of jobs and a count of CIs and relationships that have succeeded and failed. Let's look at the ribbon components. Total jobs displays a total count of reconciliation jobs that have run at least once plus jobs that have not yet run once. Executed jobs displays a count of jobs that have run at least once for the applied dataset and time period filters. Pending jobs displays the count of jobs that have not run even once for the applied filters. In the CIs ribbon, you see the total count of CIs processed in all the executed jobs. This count is bifurcated into successful and failed CIs. In the relationships ribbon, you see the total count of relationships processed in all the executed jobs, which is split into successful and failed relationships. Note that the values displayed in the jobs ribbon are runtime, but the values in the CIs and relationship ribbons are generated by the data sources utility. This message shows when the server last ran the utility. The ribbon data is specific to the tab you select at the top. Selecting the Identify tab displays the jobs, CIs, and relationship data specific to identification. Similarly, for the Merge and Purge tabs. Let us now understand the executed jobs display. Each row displays details of a single job. You can sort a column by clicking on the column name. For each job, you can view the current status, such as completed, in progress, and so on, the number of CIs and relationships that are successful and failed, the run history of that job, and the identify, merge, and purge activities configured for that job. Clicking a job name displays the job settings, such as process normalized CIs only, delete files on exit, and so on. It also includes the Identify, Merge, and Purge tabs. Here, you see the activities configured for this job, such as the source and target dataset, the precedence and merge order, and so on. From this screen, you can edit, delete, or stop a job. A major improvement in CMDB is the progressive disclosure model, where you can drill down into the failed CIs and relationships. For example, for a specific job, click the link for the number of failed CIs. For each CI with error, you can view the CI name, dataset ID, the related class name, a brief error description, and best of all, a built-in recommended action that lets you know the best way to resolve each failure. This is a major improvement in CMDB management as it lets you take definite action to resolve a failure. On similar lines, you can drill down into failed relationships and take remedial actions. For each listed job, you can drill down into the history of job runs. For the required job, click the link under Runs History. The pop-up displays the history of the job in terms of job status, the starting and end times of the job runs, the identify, merge, and purge activities executed, and the associated events. You can also filter the records based on the job status and the time period. Finally, the Activities column provides the progress details of the activities associated with the job. For the required job, click the link under Activities and check the Activities and Events tabs for details. Note that in the main reconciliation screen, as well as the drill-down screens, you have some handy features. First, you can filter the records by entering the job name. You can also refresh the display. Further, you can configure the number of rows that are displayed per page and scroll through the pages. You can create a reconciliation job from this component. Click Create Job and enter the job parameters such as the job name and description and the optional selections such as process normalized CIs only, exclude often weak CIs and so on. To create a custom job, ensure that you clear the checkbox Use standard rules for dataset. To create a standard job, ensure that you select this checkbox. In the Activities section, click Add Activity and select Identify. In the Identify tab, you must specify the name, the source and production dataset names, and other details specific to standard or custom job. Then click Add Activity and select Merge. Specify the merge details. On similar lines, select the purge activity if you want to purge the unwanted CIs from the selected datasets. Finally, set the schedule for the job and save the job. Note that the standard and custom identification rules, the qualification rules, and the precedence exceptions are not set in this component, but from the configurations menu option. A newly created job will appear initially in the Pending Jobs tab. Click the New Job. In this screen, you can edit, delete, and start the job. If you want to manually start the job, click Start Job to run it for the first time. After its first run, the job appears in the Executed Jobs tab. Back in the Reconciliation component, you can monitor the new job and track the CI errors, see the history of job runs, and so on, as explained earlier. Thank you for watching this video.